Hello everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. This video, we're going to talk about loading animation in Blazor web applications. We had this project in the previous video. Now, if I refresh this, you can see what happened, because we have loading, right? Now, when it loads and it gets to the whole application, as soon as you click on the button, what happens here? You can see you have no records for today, but there's actual record here. Okay, because the table is now loading. Unless the table is loaded before, you can see the data here, because it is calling from the API using the HTTP client. So in order to display no data found, can we have a loading icon or a loading animation which is going to just take over? Then as soon as the data is ready, we have it boom on the screen. Yes, we can. First of all, this is what you want to do. So we see here, as soon as I click on this, now watch here, no record found unless it loads it calls the API before you have it. So let's try that. Let's have a loading animation in this application. So as usual, you know, I have a small node that we're going to just learn from. Now this is what I actually want to do. If your app is processing a report, API is called and it is taking a few seconds to retrieve data. If your app is taking a little bit of time to load data, then it is good to display a loading animation. I believe this is sensible, right? So first of all, let's specify some delay in our API. So let's apply some latency in our API. Okay, so that actually when you call the API, it's going to hold maybe for 3 or 5 seconds before your data gets what delivered. So you're going to assign what the await task.delay. We pass in 3000 milliseconds, but we can actually make it at 4 seconds. So 4000 milliseconds. Okay. So let's copy this and let's go to our application. So in here, let's actually bring it here to delay. So that's artificial latency. We are creating to ourselves. Now let's save this and let's refresh the application again and see. Alright, so you can see that our data is now loaded. Now you can see we have no records to display. So it is waiting for 4 seconds before a data gets displayed. Let me click on counter, fetch data. Now count what's here. So it is there for 4 seconds before this data gets what delivered here. So in the time of doing this, you want to display the loading icon here. Instead of displaying this, let's display the loading icon. That's what you actually want to do. I hope you've gotten the concept, right? So let's move on. So in order to do that, first we have to use the sync fusion spinner to set the loading animation. Now as soon as you download data grid, you have the spinner inclusive. So if you want to find that, go to your solution explorer. Now on your client, so client project, go to dependencies, and I'll check. You see we have syncfusion.blazor.spinner is over here. So all that we need is to include this in our project. So how do you do that? Once we have located it, what is the next thing to do? Let's go to the root folder, our index file, then let's paste this link over there. So let's copy this link. Let's go to the index. So www root folder, open it, and I go to index.html. And now where we have the header, we are going to put this at the header area. Okay, so we wait for it to load, then we put it over there. So let's wait while it is loading. All right, so when it's loaded, let's paste this. So you see we have one over here, that's a team bootstrap, so let's paste it beneath. So we paste this here, and now this is using bootstrap 5, so is that going to be bootstrap 5 over here as well? Okay, so we have this. Now we are good to go. After having this, let's save this. Now when we save this, the next thing to do here is we have to import the sync fusion blazor.spinner into the import.razor. So let's copy this using, then let's go to the import, so our project, Then with the import, so you see we have import over here. Let's close this. Now let's open, we have pages. So client, we have, let's go for shared. We have import.razor, click on it. And now let's import this. So using synfusion.blazor.spinner. So you see that we have the grid here already. We're adding the spinner as well. So once you're done with this, then let's add a synfusion service to the program.cs file. So we actually have to register this. So let's check if you're not having this, then we call this. If we have it too, we leave as it is. So let's go to our project. Now with the program.cs file, so let's say program.cs file, let's check, do we have, that's a better, you can see we have it over here. Okay, so we need not to add it again, we have it there, so we leave it as it is. Now the next thing to do here is, let's see, so let's use the spinner component in any of our application pages. Now in application, this is what you're going to do. You want to, if this is for styling, for changing the spinner, okay. Now this is what you want to do. So first let's check, let me copy this, if let's copy this and in application, so that's gonna be pages index.razor. okay, index.razor. Now on top here, that's, you're gonna paste this. So let's paste this. So if then we have else. Now with this else, let's put this in it. Okay, so let's take off this from it first. Okay, so this is what we are actually trying to say. Now if we have this employees, so if we are calling this employees, so if this employees, if it is equal to null, so it means if there's no data, then you want to set the synfusion spinner visible to true. Then that is the type. So you see with the spinner type, as soon as you hit on that, let's see if you're gonna have the list. Let's say spinner type. Let's try to see if you can actually have a type here, but for now let's leave this. Now let's go for label. So loading data, you want to display loading data. I want to increase the size up to what, 50. So let's see if you can actually have the spinner. So let's see, can we have, so type is equal to, let's see if you can actually have a specific type in this. All right, so let's pass in bootstrap. So you can see we have spinner for bootstrap. Let's choose this 5. Okay, so spinner type dot bootstrap what 5. So that's gonna be the type. Okay, so now with this, so so it means if data, if employee is not equal to null, then we're gonna display this data. So that's the SF grid. Let's save this. And now do you have any addition to go about? No. So now let's go there and refresh our page and now let's see. So let's refresh, click on this, let's refresh, and now let's see what's gonna happen. So click on this or run the debug mode or control plus F5 and let's move on. So click. All right, so you can see that page is now loaded and the animation is actually working. Let's see, fetch data, counter, home. Now you see it is working. All right, so that is it. So you can actually implement this when you have your progressive web application, whereby you want to fetch data or calling API. You can display this animation at least to tell the user something. All right, so thank you guys for watching. I hope this good, and you're going to implement it as well in your application. I'm going to catch you up in the next video.